Lot of stuff going on. Oh, there's a lot of stuff going on. One day we're going to talk about these smash and grabs and these robberies and stuff. Going to get into that. But today, we're talking about the 15-year-old suspect in Tuesday's Michigan high school shooting. Excuse me, has been charged with 4 counts of first-degree murder. The teenager who is being charged as an adult also faces 1 count of terrorism causing death, 7 counts of assault with an intent to murder, and 12 counts of possession of a firearm in the commission of a felony. Now, prosecutors in the case say that the shooting at Oxford High School was not an impulsive act because there's a videotape, social media, and other digital evidence that shows premeditation.
Yep, man. Prosecutors are also reportedly considering charges against the suspect's parents because the handgun thought to have been used was recovered, and investigators believe that suspect's father had just bought the 9mm handgun on Black Friday. The boy's parents have not given permission for their minor son to speak with the police, and that is required by Michigan law. So the motive for the shooting remains unknown.
Now this is probably every parent nightmare, and laws vary state by state. But if a minor child commits murder with a parent's weapon, should the parent face equal charges? Hit us up at 866-9-RICKY and let us know what you think. So, Special K, what are your thoughts?
Yeah, I think you have to have some responsibility go to the parent, because when you buy a gun, or just like a car, if you give a kid a car with a open bottle of liquor in it, and you tell them just go have fun, you know, you're responsible for whatever happens.
But what if the parent didn't give the kid permission and the kid stole the gun?
Okay, but
well,
the parent should have had
the gun locked up where the kid can't get to it.
There you go. Yeah. You got to have it secured because, you know, you're responsible for whatever happens to it with it.
Right.
You got to take some responsibility. The parent got to.
Yeah.
You know what's so frustrating, Ricky, after the Kyle Rittenhouse case? Like, his mom was not charged. His mom physically drove him with a loaded pistol, and he did kill people.
Right.
So, like, where is the balance and where is the justice? Are parents actually responsible for the actions of their kids or not? And why do we decide one time they are and one time they aren't?
All right, y'all. Let us know what you think. 866-9-RICKY, 866-9-RICKEY. Good morning.
I do not think that the parents should face equal charges unless they deliberately provided the weapon for the child, because parents work and different things happen, and you can't always be accountable for what your child does. And so if they actually secured it and the child ended up with it, I don't think it's fair for the parent to receive equal charges. In that case, we would receive equal charges on everything from traffic tickets to skipping school.
Absolutely. A minor child, when you bring a child into this world, you are obligated to that child until that child is grown. So if a father buys a gun and that 15-year-old gets a hold of it and commits a heinous crime like that, absolutely, the father is completely responsible.
Yes, they should definitely be responsible because they knew what they were doing when they purchased that gun for them. So they definitely should be responsible. They should be in jail right along with them.
I don't think they should be charged solely with the same type of crime, but at least some type of reckless endangerment. Me and my wife, we both have firearms, but we keep them in the safe, and it's away from our kids. But definitely, it should definitely be some type of reckless endangerment, at least.
Yeah, and that's the main thing, keeping the firearms in the safe.
Yeah, he just said it, reckless endangerment. And, you know, I don't know the legal, you know.
Maybe not charged with murder.
Right. But reckless endangerment. Yeah. Because you left a dangerous weapon out where somebody could get a hold of it.
And with that being said, that will make more parents more responsible and kind of like, okay, let me make sure that we put these weapons up and hide these weapons or put them in a safe.
Right.
So, you got teenagers and kids and babies in the house or whatever. You know.
And ain't nobody saying it, but these parents probably knew their son was a little off, too. Because you know your kids. You know your kids. You know which one of your kids that you better not let get access to anything, gun or anything else.
Has there been any reports about him being bullied at school or anything?
They haven't really said anything other than one kid said that he stayed home that day because he had heard rumors that there was going to be a shooting. So the kids, there was stuff circulating around the school and people knew that this kid was kind of a weirdo.
Yeah, and he put out a video and recorded himself, put out a video saying that
he was going to
the night before shoot at the school, which is why some of the kids chose not to come.
Wow. So if you were not able to get in on the topic, hit us up on social media. All right, y'all, hit us up on our social media platforms. Let us know what you think, y'all. More Rick's Modern Morning Show coming up.